Hello friends, welcome to another video tutorial on SolidWorks Surface Modeling. This is part 6 of our SolidWorks Surface Modeling tutorial series. In this video, we will be creating a 3D model of a spoon. I have a spoon which I have measured. Let me show you the pics of spoon. This is the top view of the spoon. Okay, you can see there is a pattern engraved here. The pattern is not that much of a concern because this is detailed here. Okay, this is the bottom view and this is the side view. This profile is very important. Okay, so let's come to the 3D modeling part. So we will start SolidWorks and now I will click on new and part. Okay, since I have told you that I have measured most of the dimensions, so let's start with this. Okay, the first part I will be doing is this part. Okay, this profile, this is important here. Everything else is can be assumed, but this profile is very important here. The capacity of a tablespoon depends upon this profile. Okay, so I will click on front plane and sketch. First of all, I will draw a box here. This box is the bounding box for the profile. Consider it as the extremities here. Okay, so the dimension I have measured is the length from this point to this point is around 55. Okay, this dimension is around 8 mm. Okay, so I will exit sketch now. I'm not going to do any modeling here. Now we will have to draw the profile from the top. Let me show you this profile. Okay, so top plane, sketch, normal to. Now I am going to draw a box here. Okay, let's make this box coincident with these points. Okay, I will select this point and this line and create a midpoint relation. I will repeat the same process here. Okay, for the width I have measured it. It is around 36 mm here. Okay, this is also the bounding box. Bounding box is very helpful in these kind of models because it helps us in creating tangent relation, and we have always in mind the boundaries in which we have to create the model. Okay, now I will create a reference plane on this point. Okay, now we have to create the profile for the spoon. Okay, so Let's create a sketch here. Normal to. I will select a center line first here. A horizontal center line along the origin. Now I will create some dimensions here. This is an important part. Okay. Create a tangent relation here. Another 3-point arc. Create a tangent relation between these two. Create a tangent relation here also. Okay. Now I will again use the 3-point arc. Let's make it coincident on this point. Let's just select this and create a Pierce relation. Select this and this. Create a tangent relation here. Select both of these arcs. Create a tangent relation here also. So we have created all the tangent relations we needed. Now I will smart dimension it. Okay, this should be around 17. Okay. Let's select all of these. Since we have also selected a center line here, only one center line. So if we click on mirror entities, it will create the mirror here automatically. Okay. Let's click on exit sketch. Now I will draw the profile for the curvature here. Front plane. Sketch. Normal to. This profile is also mostly arcs. Okay. So let's select 3-point arc. Okay. Let's dimension it. Okay. Now exit sketch. Now we have to create the surface here. There are many ways we can do it, okay, but the best way is to use filled surface command. Click on surfaces, filled surface, select this profile. Since we have not selected our constraint curve, it will just create a planar surface here. So in constraint curves, select this profile. Okay, as you can see that the curvature of the spoon is here. Let's see curvature analysis. Okay, this looks nice. If you don't understand curvature here, I have explained this in my video tutorial on surface curvature analysis and continuity. For now, I will just tell you that if you see sudden change in color, like if some color here is red, black or something in between, then there is a sudden deviation and surface quality is poor. Okay, unless you want that kind of surface quality. Okay, let's disable curvature. Okay, I will hide this plane here. So we have created the surface of the spoon here. Now we have to create the handle here. Okay, for handle I will go to front plane, sketch, normal 2. Okay, now I will draw a line like this. Let's dimension it. The height is around 36 mm. Okay. Ten mm. Strokes. Okay. Let's extrude it. For extrusion, let's make it middle plane and around 16 mm. Okay. Okay, this is too high here. Okay. Let's edit the sketch. I want to maintain this slope. Okay, so I will create a angular dimension. I will select this other. Okay, now this 10 mm, select this dimension, other, make this driven. Okay, now make this driving dimension, change this to 37.5 or 38. Okay, I changed this dimension because I need some room here, some extra space, so that I can patch this. Okay, okay, this looks okay now. Now we have to cut some part here. Okay, here, so that we can create a surface here. Okay, so top plane, sketch. Okay, make sure this line is vertical and this is horizontal. Okay, yeah. 1.5. Okay, no, not this. Let's create a arc here like this. Okay, smart dimension 12 mm. Go to surface, trim and remove this portion. Click OK. As you can see that we removed some space here. Okay, there is some mistake we did. Maybe we don't want a circular arc here. Okay, so let's edit this sketch, make this construction. Okay, exit sketch. There should be an error now. Okay, delete this surface trim one. Again select this surface trim and remove this. Okay, this looks nice now. Now we will create a lofted surface between these edges, this edge and this edge. Okay, lofted surface, select this edge and this edge. Okay, now go to start and constraint, tangency to face, click on OK. Okay, this looks nice. Let's check curvature. Okay, this is looking nice. Okay, this is perfect. Okay, now we will create some rounded corners. Okay, so here, because you can see there is a sharp and this handle is too thick. Okay, so go to top plane, sketch, normal to. Now select line tool and from this endpoint draw it like this and go. Okay, let me tell you something. You can see that sometime I am using a line command and I automatically switches to arc. I don't use any keyboard key for that. I just go to this point back and you can see that there are two circles here, and when I come here it will show me an arc. Okay, I will make this coincident here. Now create a tangent relation here. Okay, there is some. Okay, now create a tangent relation. SolidWorks is sometime, you know, act weird, so we have to adjust it so that we can get our desired result. Okay, so let's start with the dimension here, 6.5. okay, let's make a line from here to here. Okay, create a tangent relation here. Okay, maybe I created a wrong coincident relation. Okay, now it works. Wow, before it was not working, but now it works. This is because SolidWorks have a lot of inconsistency in this software. Okay. We have a tangent relation here also. Okay. So let's create a horizontal line. Okay. Now select all these mirror entities. Okay. We need one more dimension here. Okay. So I will just make these around 6 mm. Okay. Go to surfaces, trim surface, remove these parts. Okay. Go to knit, select all these three surfaces, click on okay. One more thing, I have hidden tangent edges. You can enable them here. Tangent edges visible. So you can see that there are partitions of four faces here. This is different face. This is all the three faces are different. But if you disable the tangent edges view, then you can see that these are actually smooth here. Okay. Let me check the curvature analysis here. Okay. Okay. This looks fine. Okay, now we will use the thicken feature here. Okay, go to surfaces, thicken, and select this here. Okay, so I measured the thickness for this spoon and it was around 1.5 completely. So I will just use 0.75 for both sides. Okay. That means 1.5 mm in total. Click on OK. So you can see that we have created a basic 3D model for the spoon. Okay. Now we will add some features here. Okay. For example, I will use chamfer and select these edges. Okay. Click on OK. Now add fillet feature here also. Around 2 mm. Okay. So this is a basic 3D model for the spoon. If you want to add some kind of pattern here, you can do it also. I will just select this face and sketch. I am going to use a random pattern here. Okay. Offset entities, reverse, 1 mm. Okay. Feature, extruded cut, 0.1 mm. Because the engraving in most of these kind of products is 0.1 mm. Okay. Now again select inside face and sketch, again offset entities, again reverse, this time extrude 0.1. Okay. Offset entities, reverse, this time extrude cut. So you can see that I will just basically repeat this command here. Okay. So this is our basic pattern here. Okay. You can also use some kind of sketch driven pattern here, okay, or fill pattern, but I will not recommend that those, okay, for now. So thank you for watching this video tutorial, and if you like this video, please like, click on like button and share this with your friends, colleagues and other students. And please subscribe to my channel to continue receiving more updates like this. Okay. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.